I'm Scott. In this video, I'm going to cover how to repair a rear window defroster on a Jeep Wrangler Unlimited. This is for the Jeeps that come with a three-piece hard top. Now, this will cover your Jeeps from 2007 to 2018. The repair I'll be covering for your rear window defroster on your Jeep Wrangler Unlimited is when the contact point breaks away from the rear window. I'll show you how to repair that. There are two ways to repair a contact point that breaks away from the rear windshield. I'll cover both of those repair methods. I'll also provide an overview on how the rear window defroster works. What's all the magic that goes on when you press that button on your console? All right, let's get started. In this video clip, I just wanted to show you right here where the old nub was actually soldered on. You can see that piece of solder broke off right there. That's where the clip was laying before, and it's hooked up in this housing, you know, like that. So in here, we can see the back of the nub. Now that's still inserted in this connector at this point. In this clip, I'm going to use my screwdriver to remove the little nub that's right there. And remember, that nub is what I'm going to solder onto the windshield, the rear windshield. Now, this nub is tiny, so I'm just putting this piece of duct tape on here so that when I pry this nub loose, if it does go flying across the garage, I'll be able to find it because they have this piece of tape to it. So it's kind of difficult. I'm just getting my little screwdriver between the nub and the rubber part, and I'm just prying it loose. And if you can see, it's starting to come loose now. And there, it just came off. So there's the nub. Let me see if I can show you that better. So here's the nub that will actually get pried to soldered to the windshield right here. I'm not showing that very good, but I'll show it better later. And then here's the inside of the clip. And then this clip will just go over top of this nub, and we'll actually position it like that. And then we'll be good to go. Right here, I'm showing you a close-up of the nub that pried off of that connector. So this is the connector, will be clipped to this part of the nub. And if I flip it over, this is the back side of the nub that we've been seeing all along. And this will get resoldered to the window, the contact pad on the rear window. In this clip, we're gonna test the continuity of the rear window defroster, the wiring up here. So, you know, we have one connector pad over here and one connector pad over here. We want to make sure that the electricity is flowing freely through all these wires. So we check for continuity. So to do this, we use our multimeter. I'm going to use my two connector points. Right now, the meter says 0.0L. If I touch these two connectors together, we complete the circuit. It goes to 0.00. That means my circuit's complete. If I take them apart, that means there's a break in the circuit. So now we're going to touch this one to the left connector pad in the rear defroster. And we'll take the black and touch it to the right connector pad in the rear defroster. And you'll see now we're at 0.0. That tells us we got a complete circuit going on in the wiring in the rear window defroster. Now if I remove one of the probe, now I've got an open connection. So it's not a complete circuit. I put it back, we got a complete circuit. I remove it on the left side, it's open. I put it back, now we have a closed circuit. So that test there verifies that the wiring here on the rear window, this rear window defroster, that's a complete circuit. In this clip, we're gonna test the voltage on the two connectors here and here to make sure when we turn the rear window defroster on in the cabin that I'm actually getting 12 volts coming through here. Then 12 volts will go through the wiring on the rear window of the defroster, and that will generate the heat from the resistance of the wires to do the defrosting and melting. So I want to verify I'm getting 12 volts between my two connectors. So to verify I got 12 volts between my two connectors, I'm going to put my multimeter on DC current. And then I'm going to do a pre-check. I check up here with one connector, our probe, and over here on another probe. And I look at my multimeter, and it's like basically no current's coming through there. Okay, so now let me go turn the rear window defroster on. Okay, to turn the rear window defroster on, I put the ignition in the accessories and I push the rear window defroster button and the light came on. So now I touch here at this connection point and I come over here and touch to this connection point and there it is. I got 12.3 volts. So the electrical circuit that provides power to the rear window defroster, I just opened it. That whole circuit, I'm going to touch it again. That's giving me 12.3 volts. So that's a closed circuit. So that's a good circuit. So what this is telling me when I do put the nub, solder my nub here and then I put my connector on it, that I will complete both circuits together and that will let me run the 12.3 volts through this wiring and the rear window defroster will work. In this clip, I've got the nub that we're going to solder to the rear window. And this is the part where the connector is going to go onto it. And then if I flip this over, this is the back side. This is actually what's going to, and be soldered to the rear windshield. So the first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to put more solder on here. We call it tinning. So that when I put this up on the windshield, I'm going to touch my soldering iron to it. It's going to be hot and it's going to melt to solder that tin on here and it's going to connect to the windshield. So first thing I'm going to do is just add a little solder paste on here. And that will clean it when we add the soldering to it, make the solder stick to it. Because this is old solder. Whoops. Of course, you're going to edit all this guy. Now I'm adding soldering paste to this. And the soldering paste will help the new solder stick to the old solder. That old solder is a... The old solder just gets old and they call it... It'll break away. It calls cold solder joints on electronics, but it just breaks over time. All right, so now I'm going to take my solder along with my soldering iron and I'm going to add some solder to this. And you see where that's all smoking? That's cleaning it all up, the soldering paste, and we're just adding, that's just a bubble of solder. Let's see if we can get in a little bit closer to that. So you see that it's got a big bubble of solder right there. And that will help that nub stick to the window. When I press it on there and I put the soldering on it, it will transfer heat, remelt that solder bubble, and it'll stick to the windshield. Okay. In this clip, this video, we're now going to clean this with some soldering paste and then tin it with some solder. And that's going to prep it so that we can solder the nub to it. So the first thing I'm going to do, just add a little bit of solder paste up here. You know, that's old solder. This will clean it and will help the new solder stick to it. So we just wipe that on there. And then take my soldering iron, my solder, and I'm just gonna come up here, clean it all that. And then we're gonna tin it up just a little bit.
All right, so I've cleaned that. And it's got just a little solder. It's hard to put solder on there upside down because the gravity's pulling the solder away. But I've cleaned that, and I think we're gonna be good to go. I think my nub will stick on that.
Okay, right now I'm getting ready to prepare to put this little nub on the rear windshield. I got this long Allen wrench, and I want to attach it to the nub so I can hold it so while I'm soldering it on, it doesn't fall off and go flying in my garage and I lose it. And to do that, I'm gonna just use a little bit of this Arch and Craft tacking stick. It's like just a little bitty piece of putty. And I put it on the inside of that nub. And I'm just gonna take my Allen wrench and stick it on there. That way, I won't get, when I put heat on the nub with the soldering iron, I'll have a little glove on, but it won't transfer that heat to my hand and burn it, and I can keep this steady while I'm soldering it on there.
We're on to one of the final pieces. I have my Allen wrench with that little tacky putty stuff, and I got my nub. And my nub has been tinned with solder. So I'm just pushing it up here at the contact point. And I'm coming, I put my soldering iron here. And it should transfer the heat. And it's melting everything in, and it's starting to stick together. Hopefully you can see that on the video. I'm just gonna do it at different points, just to make sure all this heat is transferred. So the solder on that nub is sticking. You can see it move just a little bit. That's the solder underneath melting. All right, I'll give it a couple seconds. And we'll just pull away, and our nub's up there. Okay, after we get that, we do have some solder on the outside of this nub that needs to come off so that this clip will actually clip over the lip of that nub. So I'm just taking some soldering braid. I'm gonna stick it there and try to clean up some of this. And that looks good. It's been about 10 minutes since we soldered the nub on there. So I can touch it, it's not warm, it's not hot, it's not burning me. So let's go ahead and try, and we'll clip this connector onto this nub. There we go, that's in. Put the wiring in. All right. All right, I got my temperature gun. I'm going to take the temperature of the windshield, the rear windshield. I got a point right on one of the defroster lines. Looks like it's 99 degrees. And so now I'll go in, I'll turn the rear window defroster on and see if it heats it up some. Now I'm back about 2 minutes later, and I've got the gun pointing. It's 107 degrees, so it's going up. I'm pointing the red LED right on the line.
So I'll pick a different line, 109, 110, come back up, 109. So the defroster is working. It's warming it up. That one's 108. All right, let's see how to go. Okay, it continues to go up. Oops. All right, it continues to go up. Just work my way down the lines. 109. 106. This one always seems to be a little bit lower than the other ones. 104 is the lowest, and they start picking up. So it looks like it's stabilizing around 112 to 114. Every now and then you get a big number. There was a 117. So, but right around 114. That wraps up this video showing you how to repair a rear window defroster on a Jeep Wrangler Unlimited, a 2016 Sport Edition, where the contact point broke away from the rear windshield. Hopefully this information helps you maintain your Jeep. Now keep watching my YouTube channel, as I'll be releasing other videos that show you how to maintain your Jeep. We're at that point of the video where I ask you to go ahead, click on that red subscribe button below. And if you want to get notified when I add content to my YouTube channel, ring that bell. All right, if you like this video, click the thumbs up. If you have any positive feedback, leave it in the comment section below. All right, have a great day. Now go out there, climb in your Jeep, drive it, and enjoy our wonderful countryside.